Paul's prayer, actually the end of his prayer, when he says, now unto him, right, who is able to do so much more, exceedingly above, immeasurably more than all we ask or imagine. I want you to hear this in all we've been talking about. According to the power that is at work in us, the glory in the church and in Christ Jesus for generations, now and forever. What is the exceedingly above, the immeasurably more God is doing, right? Through the power that is at work in us, is making us look like Jesus. Not that he's not doing more than we're asking in any way, but what if that's the most important more? More than we could hope for, he's doing by the power of his Spirit, the same Spirit that raised Jesus from the dead, lives in us. So I want to invite you tonight to ask God for more of himself. To ask God, right? To teach us how to love him and trust him. To teach us what it looks like to desire him, not just with our words, but with our lives. That we would not half-heartedly receive this treasure of knowing the only true God and Jesus Christ, whom he sent. There's no place to be embarrassed. Embarrassment keeps us from receiving what God has for us. If we don't know, if we don't understand, let's ask him. Right? Let's receive. Let's let Jesus teach us. Right? Because that's what he said, learn from me. As individuals, but let's encourage one another to ask. Let's ask for one another that God would give more of himself, that we would be able to receive more of himself, and that we would trust him, and we would follow him, and we would surrender, and we would partner with him to be transformed as people, to be transformed as his body, and then to reflect his glory, to show him rightly to a world that desperately needs to know him.